Ladies and gentlemen, this is Envoy of Kairos, back for another speed paint, and this one is another commission. So, last time we had one for my buddy Sean and his character Rain, and now we have a newer fan of mine who really wanted me to work on his Monster Hunter character and a little bit of personal lore that he built up for them. So, he didn't actually give me the name of his character, and I'm recording this the day before it's supposed to go up, so I don't really have time to get it since they're unavailable at the moment. But I do know that the name of the little hatchling atop his head is Venus. And yeah, making her was a challenge because I'm not used to realistic, scaly, detailed monster designs. It's just not something I've ever really done before. So this was a bit of a challenge, as was the details of the armor. I'll be honest, this one had me a bit stumped at times. Designing armor and all the details within it, especially when you're using scale mail or chain mail or something of the sort, it can get pretty difficult and pretty obnoxious. And although there isn't quite scale mail in this, and there's only a tiny bit of chain mail, there's a lot of scale-based details in the armor that really challenged me. Not that I'm against a challenge, I could definitely use more of them more frequently. And this one definitely helped me to expand my talents, realize a couple of different methods. Throughout this speed paint, you might notice me using multiple different methods to achieve the same results, with varying success. It was very experimental, and I feel like the end result turned out pretty well, and I know what techniques to try and stick to for each of these results. As for how well it turned out on individual steps, well, you guys know from my Kirby speed paint that I now have a decent amount of experience with lighting and shading gold. This in particular gave me a lot more experience with that, and then topped it off with some brass. And yeah, I think the lighting turned out really good here. The difficult part of it is shading and texturing scratches and creases. That was difficult, obnoxious. Eventually I managed it. Could I do better giving it another couple of passes? Maybe, but I had to keep the commissioner's budget in mind. And for the amount of time that I had available to do this, I'm quite impressed with myself, honestly. I really worked my ass off to make this work. The end results are, yeah, generally with the gold and the armor as a whole, I'm pretty satisfied. But there's a lot more besides that that I really put into with the texture work. Then there's the belts holding together some parts of the armor. You really don't think about it too much, but there's a lot more texture to leather and general cloth straps and such than you really consider at first when starting up this sort of thing. I'm not used to doing realism so much, but I think I got a hell of a lot closer with this one. When working on the belts, I made sure to represent the wear and tear and the fading of the texture and color on the edges. And then, of course, added some cracking to the edges as it becomes worn and hardened and eventually starts to crack and break along the sides. I'm sure you've all seen that happen on belts and such. So I wanted to do that properly, and I feel that turned out pretty well, too. And then, of course, the scales on the upper part of the chest plate. My god, that took forever. There's a lot of individual details to do. I knew I could make it haphazard in the initial stages to make it look more organic, and I think that turned out pretty well. I mean, when doing organic textures, you're given a lot more leeway. So that did help here. But it's also a bit of troubleshooting to make something organic also just look right. It's you can easily go a little too far with how loosely you represent it, especially when handling a more realistic depiction like this. Overall, the scales turned out pretty good, but there's a lot of difference between that and the scales on Venus atop his head. We'll get to her in a minute. From there, there's the cloth texture, largely in the scarf around his neck, and I'm not quite sure what to call that portion under it that's native to the Goldrathian armor. But you clearly know what I mean just looking at this. Cloth texture took a little bit of troubleshooting for me to find a fitting texture to use for it, and then of course copying it all over the place as an overlay layer, shifting it about here and there to get different angles. And overall, that worked out pretty well. Then there's, well, it's subtle, but I did work some texture into the skin of his face and such. It's a very subtle texture. You really have to be paying attention to really notice it, but it's that way a lot of the time with depicting skin properly. So overall, I feel that turned out pretty well. Skin tone turned out pretty decent, and the bags under his eyes and the general shading around the eyes as a whole turned out pretty well. Eyes are something that I've struggled with consistently when doing human characters, although I'd say the nose is something I have a little more difficulty with, but in both cases, this turned out pretty well. I think I might start doing a lot more human characters after this, purely because I'm just better at it now. Might do another pass over my original ones for control. And then, of course, there's his hair. Texturing hair isn't too difficult. I've had hair and fur down for a very long time. It's largely just creating a heavy noise layer and then motion blurring it in a particular direction to give it that angular, stranded look. Makes it look very peppered and layered, and overall that turned out pretty well here. Then, finally, we move on to Venus, the rose gold Rathian hatchling. I'll admit, getting her scales and hide to generally look good was also quite new for me. But I knew I could do it with a different approach than the heavy, detailed scales that were on the upper part of the chest plate. Largely because there is actually official artwork of freshly hatched Rathalos, the male sibling to the Rathian. And they lack a lot of that detail. Their scales are far less defined, their bodies are much smoother, and a lot of the plating on their heads has not developed yet, as that grows with them. Essentially, more plates growing out between the ones they initially start with, which are very few. So, I knew I could go with a simpler, subtler, softer look for her, which I feel complements the rose gold quite nicely. But being rose gold scales, I did still need to work in a good deal of heavy contrast on the lighting, but it's not actual gold, so it's subtler than doing it with actual metal. I found that using a slightly reddish brown was the best approach for shading all of this rose gold, and then just a very, very bright pink for the lighting. All in all, I feel that turned out pretty well, and her closed eyes and subtly leaning into his hand as he scratches her chin, that turned out impeccably. And then, of course, there's the spots on the wings, which, you know, rose gold Rathians, they don't actually exist, it was a custom thing, but we do have gold Rathians, and the spots on their wings are obviously very different colors, and I had to figure out what to do about that myself. But I went for something kind of similar. and feel they blend in with the folds and texture of the wing pretty well. With all of that combined, the only thing remaining was a background, and that took me a little. But, you know, I don't ever really do the backgrounds in the speed paint. Largely, the big issue with the background was I couldn't put much more time into it for him, so we ended up resorting to a blurred and deleveled screenshot of one of the home areas in Monster Hunter World. In the end, I think that works out pretty well. But the real focus of the piece was the character and the hatchling. And I think those turned out pretty damn great. Hope you're satisfied with this, man. I certainly am. But for now, this is Envoy of Kairos signing out. And I'll see you guys again soon for another speed paint in 2 weeks. And this time, I'll probably be getting back to my own designs. But which of my personal series will I be doing? I guess you'll just have to wait and see. Later, guys.